Yo, what the fuck is up? That there is probably the best pizza you'll ever see. Mr. 45 Bullet had some. That is old school pizza, what they put the sauce on the top and the cheese underneath, and the dough is all homemade and risen and all that shit. And people come from all over to get this pizza. It's very famous. It's in Clifton Heights, and it's called Gaetano's. There's a lot of different Gaetano's. But this is by itself, trust me. It's not any other Gaetano's. Anyway, just wanted to show you what good pizza looks like. That's what it looks like. It looks like a mess, but that's what good pizza looks like. We're going to do a cooking video today, because everyone's been requesting it. And I'm going to make fried chicken cutlets with like Italian style. And we're going to make mashed potatoes Italian style. We're going to make garlic mashed potatoes with Parmesan cheese. Oh yeah, you're gonna like this one. Alright, dudes. There's that fucking siren again. You know what? I couldn't have timed that perfect, couldn't I? There it is. The Germans are coming. Anyway. Yeah, I pissed off one guy from New Jersey. Yeah, there it gives you an idea. That'll give you an idea of how many people that live in Jersey are actually proud of that place. One guy out of hundreds of comments got offended. First of all, the last impression I want to give is I ain't got nothing against Jersey people. Christ, I might as well be one of them. I lived there for 20 years. I got three sisters that live in New Jersey. And everybody hates it. It's not the people in New Jersey. It's the Jersey government, as I call them. It's the state of New Jersey. It's the legislators and all them idiots. Nothing to do with the people. The people in New Jersey are cool as shit. You know, some of the best people I ever met. But it's just a horrible place to live. If you want to have that American freedom feeling, that's not the place to live. Okay? It's just like California, New York, New Jersey. And a couple other places. They're the only ones that I know because they're like the worst places to live if you own firearms. So nothing against the people in New Jersey. It's the state of New Jersey. You got that? It's a fucking big difference. Anyway, whatever. I knew someone was gonna get ass hurt, but I couldn't believe, you know, in all the 20 years that I've lived there, I swear to God, I never met anybody that lived there that was a proud native of the state, like was a proud New Jerseyan. Never heard of it. If you ever watch Hollywood movies, when they always dump on a state or cut up a state or do a spoof on a state, it's always Jersey. So I'm not the only one that feels that way. But like I said, the people are cool. Good food. North Jersey's real cool. There's a lot of culture up there. Real good pizza up there. South Jersey, that's where I lived. All I can say is, thumbs down in South Jersey, okay? But like I said, good people. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not going to sit here and apologize for it. I just don't want you to think that it's the people. It's the state. Same with New York. It's not the people. It's the state. Same with California. Well, California, there is some fucked up people there. Anyway. These are the guns I got keeping me company today for this cooking video. We're coming in 1080 HD. I'm going to give it a shot. Well, it's 1080p. I could go real high quality, but I don't know if it'll handle it. But my man Davin the Geek gave me some pointers, so I'm gonna try this 1080p first. And we got the Springfield 1911 on the lower left, we got Glock 27 on the lower right, and we got that beautiful arsenal there sitting up by itself. Okay, now what we're gonna make today is chicken cutlets and then mashed potatoes Italian style. You know, when you go Italian style, I hate to admit it, it always tastes a little better, don't it? Oh yeah. I'm going to show you how to make garlic mashed potatoes. I don't know if you ever had garlic mashed potatoes, but they are friggin' awesome. So I'm going to go through that, try not to make it too long. There's a couple pounds of fresh chicken breasts right there. And there goes another fucking fire engine. I hate this fucking neighborhood. I got some Italian style breadcrumbs. Show you the little trick I do with that. And there's your seasonings you're going to need. is salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, a block of Parmesan cheese, and garlic. And there's a certain way I use the garlic, and then the garlic mashed potatoes I'll show you. So, let's get rolling. Oh, I got a shout out for my man Slicky. If anyone's seen Slicky's channel, it's S, I think he uses the one as an L. It's S1ICCY. Mr. Uncle Slicky Beans. That dude's funny, man. Go check his channel out. He's just starting out, but he is a natural because he's just a funny dude. There's no act. He just lets loose. And the way he talks and the way he handles people and the way he reviews his guns makes me laugh my ass off. So, I love his channel. My man Slicky Beans. Alright. Talk to you. Alright. Got my potatoes lined up. I just got done washing them off. There's only about 4 people eating, so I think that's plenty of potato there. Now, when you make garlic mashed potatoes, you don't want to take all the skin off. No. You want to peel about half the potato, about from here down, and leave the other half with the skin on. Because when you mix it in the mixer, you want the little pieces of skin all through it. That's part of the recipe. It's pretty cool. I don't know if anyone ever ate at Carrabba's, but when they have garlic mashed potatoes, there's little pieces of skin in it. They use red skin potatoes, but you can do it with either one. The red skin potatoes, the skin's a little thinner, but it doesn't matter. You can do it with the brown or red, don't matter. And you know what irritates me today? Not because he's home. These kids today, with this school shit, everything's changed for the worse. You ever notice how often your kids are off from school? Didn't they just go back to school? They just fucking went back. And they've been off like 5 times already. A teacher's thing, election day. Now, they're always home. Start late day. I got to go in at, the bus don't come at 7:30 today, Dad. It comes in at 10. I have 3 half days this week. Hello? The friggin' parents at work. Alright? Oh my God, why do they always do that? They're always off. When I went to school, I don't remember that. Does anyone remember that back in the 70s? Having all them days off? No. The only fucking days we had off were fucking Christmas and New Year's and all that shit. Thanksgiving. We didn't have all these half days all week. You know what I'm saying? Damn. I just hate when the kids are home because I can't get nothing done. So what I'm going to do is, my man's home, so his little ass, I'm going to put him to work. He's going to be peeling half these potatoes. So he's going to help me out. So anyone else goes through that shit with the kids being off from school all the time. Could you imagine, like right now I work part-time because I'm not busy, but if I had a full-time job, what would I do if the kid had half days all week? They don't give a shit. They don't care about these teachers. They can care less about your schedule. Anyway, that's in PA anyway. Maybe PA's gay that way. Alright, be right back. Alright, everyone wanted to see the camera I got. There it is. This is my new camera. It's a Nikon Coolpix S8100. Pretty cool camera. Goes up to all the way up to HD 1080. Way up there. Okay? And that's what we're doing right now. We're in 1080. Not full 1080, just 1080p. And that's the camera, and it was like $300, and it does all kinds of shit. Now, when my son was home from school today because of election day, he thought he was going to sit here and watch cartoons. No, not in the Canella house. There's none of that. Okay, this is what he's doing. He's sitting and peeling. Okay, how you making out, dude?
All right.
You're sitting and peeling?
Mm-hmm.
Got your potatoes up there? They look good. Them potatoes look like, these potatoes look like some chicks I've dated when I was like really drunk. They look like that. I ain't kidding you, man. Alright, so he's going to peel them, and what he's doing, he's only peeling half of them, right? Not all the way. Just peel half. Let's see what one looks like that you peel already. So they know. Show it. No, to the camera, dude, not me.
I am.
See that? Flip it around, show on the other side. Yeah. See all the skin's on there? That's how you want it, like that. Okay? You look good in HD, dude. Nice shirt.
Thanks.
I got them all brainwashed in here. Frank Sinatra and the Flyers. Alright. Let me get rolling here. There's a lot of things I gotta show. Alright, there's my friggin' wet chicken. Now, if you've been watching my videos for a long time now, everyone knows what I mean by when I say wet chicken. Right? If you're new to the channel, usually my term wet chicken means when a woman shaves down there, it looks like a wet chicken. Well, this isn't that wet chicken. This is a real wet chicken. When you first take chicken breasts out of a packet, it looks like that, and it's all slimy. So you want to run some hot water on it, get all the slime off, and then I'm going to trim all the fat off. I'm going to trim all the cartilage out of it, because even though it's boneless, it has a lot of shit in there. And then I cut them very thin, okay, because I like my cutlets thin. Alright, so that's what we're going to do in about a second. I'll be right back. I'm working on the chicken, and I'm cutting all the cartilage off it. Like, see this spot here? See that nasty spot there? That is nasty. I cut that shit off. Gotta have a nice, real sharp knife. These ain't good knives. These are crap, but they're real sharp because they're new. Gardevoir will tell you, these are shit knives. Someday I'll get a good set of knives like from Henkel. Everything German's great. Yeah, that sounds like the ShamWow commercial. Anyway, you want to get this off of there. You don't want to know what I call it when I cut that. I'm going to tell you what I call it. You don't want to be eating a chicken cutlet and then you bite down and it feels like you bit someone's clit, okay? You want to take that thing out of there. See it? Little man in a boat. That has to go, man. Okay? That has to go. All that shit. And what I do is just trim every piece of fat off of here I can. Because the more fat off it, the more tender it'll be when you're chewing it. You don't want to be chewing fat. Not chicken fat. Chicken fat's very tough. Alright? So now what I'm going to do is, that's all pretty much done. Now what I'm going to do is a little bit more here. You drag it to the end with the knife and then just take it off. Okay? I'm not going to show you every step because the video will get fucking long. You put it this way. Now, a lot of guys pound their chicken. I pound my chicken probably twice a day, but this chicken, I don't pound it at all. You don't have to, really. You can. It helps, but I don't. Because the whole secret to chicken, if anyone knows how to cook, is you don't cook it too long. If you cook it too long, it gets like rubber. You want to cook it quick. So another trick is make it thin so it cooks in the oil. So it cooks in the oil quick. Thanks for the interruption. Okay? So what I do is I cut them thin. Press my hand on it. Alright? Like it's a nice firm honey. Press your hand on it. And I make it real thin, man. Like that. See how nice and thin they are? That's what I'll do. And then I'll fill up a bowl of egg and milk and let them sit in there for a while. Alright, be right back. Alright, here's my friggin' eggs. I got four eggs in there. Alright, and I'm gonna get some whole milk. Some people use water, some people use milk, whatever. I like milk. Pour some milk in there. It stretches the eggs so I don't have to waste eggs. And I'll just beat this with a whisk. Get it? I'll beat that with a whisk, and then when I'm done cutting all the cutlets up, I'll put them all in there and let them soak for like 20 minutes, then I'll start breading them, and I'll show you that system. Alright, my chicken's soaking in the milk. My potatoes are done being peeled, almost. He's got one more to go. And this is for people that really don't cook, so you're going to hear a lot of things that you probably already know. That people that cook all the time, but there's people that don't cook all the time. I've always cooked, even through all my marriages. All my marriages that didn't work. Must be me. Maybe it is me. But here it is. I'll show you one. I'm not going to do every one. When you cut potatoes for making mashed potatoes, one of the most important things is you want to try to keep everything the same size. You know why? Cooking time. They'll cook more evenly. You know what I'm saying? So, See how they're basically all the same size? That means they will, when one's done, they'll all be done, you know, pretty much. So that's real important. Try to remember that. That makes things a lot easier. You don't want a big one and a little one and a big one and a tiny one, because you might check a tiny one and the big one's not done and all that shit. Okay, so that's what I'm working on right now. All right, homos. My chicken's been soaking in the eggs for long enough. I got a plate of breadcrumbs there and an empty plate. Now what you do is, got my pot of water, you know, not even boiling yet. I'm getting that ready. When they're boiling, I'll throw all the potatoes in. Here's the potatoes. They're all the same size. Try to be. I'll throw them in as soon as that comes to a boil with some salt. Okay, now you got breadcrumbs, right? Now if you can either just use the breadcrumbs and have it taste good, or you can do what I'm going to show you and have it taste awesome. Okay? I'm not taking no credit for this. This is my mom's for years, all this stuff. I used to watch her like a hawk. I love to eat and I love to cook. I thought it was gay until I found out a lot of guys do that. So now I tell people I don't care. Alright. What you want to do, try to get, if you can, breadcrumbs, let's say Italian style breadcrumbs. You want them, that's the kind you want to get. Okay? Now, but it's not enough. It's not enough. Okay, you have to season the breadcrumbs. So, salt. Alright. Fresh pepper. Alright. Onion powder. This is the trick. This is one of the main things, the onion powder. Be generous with it. Alright. And garlic powder. That's all you really need to do with that. And all you do is just kind of get your hands and just toss it around. You know what I mean? Just like that. Make sure. Now they're seasoned a step further. Now they're going to taste real yummy. So what I do is, and I'll show you one. So I'll get a cutlet. Let's try to find a good one. Here's a good one. Nice one. You just lay it in there like that. Okay. Flip it around. Okay, and that's ready. That's beautiful. That's one breaded cutlet. Now I'll do that to the whole thing. Okay? And then I'll show you the next step. I don't have steps, I don't measure, I just do it. There's none of that. I don't do that kind of stuff. Alright dudes, all the cutlets are breaded. They're all done. They're breaded, not done. And your hands will look like this when you're done. You know? Looks like I just got done fingering Rosie O'Donnell on a bad yeast infection. Yeah, fuck you, Rosie O'Donnell. I hate her. We need less of her. Lots of less of that woman. Yeah, what are we doing now? Still waiting for the pot of water to boil. Because once that's boiled, I'll throw the potatoes in. Once the potatoes are done boiling, I don't really know how long it takes, 20 to 30 minutes. It takes a while. Then I'll show you how to season them up and get them ready for really awesome mashed potatoes. Alright? Alright, see you soon. Alright. I think my oil's hot enough. You don't want the oil too hot. You don't want these things to be smoking. You just want them to sizzle till they're done. You don't want them like, psh, you know, you don't want that, okay? So I'm going to do one and show you. That oil might be a little hot. Here's a little trick Garb War 1981 taught me. Put a little cold water on your finger and just, if you hear it do that, that means you're good to go. Don't put too much in it because it'll splatter all over. Just a drop. That's ready. That sounds a little too hot to me. So I'm going to turn this down. Okay, and we're going to put the first batch in there. Yeah, that's a little hot, but it's okay. Whoops, see how nice and thin they are? That's the way you want them, because you don't want to have to cook them long. You want to get them in and get them out. You get them in and get them out, and they'll be real tender when you eat them. I can't fit that one in there. Alright, so let's just see what they do. Hey, you know what? My water's boiling, so I gotta throw the potatoes in there. When they're done, I'll show you how nice they look. See in a little bit. Alright, just got done frying all the cutlets. They are done. Let's go see what they look like. Over here. There they are. Looking pretty fucking good in HD. Hopefully it comes in as good as I think it's going. Alright, that'll feed about 4 people easy. There's a lot in there to pile on top of each other. That's the color you want them. You want them like a golden brown. Okay? And a little bit of parsley on top. And that's it. They're ready. I'll cover them up, put them away. And, you know, usually when I cook, I like to eat them right after they're done because they're the best. But I'm doing a video for you guys, so they'll have to be reheated later when the family gets home. But it's cool. It's worth it. It's still going to be good. Potatoes are still boiling. Let's check on the gun and see what the hell they're doing. See what you guys are doing over here. What the fuck are you doing? What's that Glock doing? Will you get your nose out of that 1911's ass? That's the second time I've seen you fucking do that. I know it's a sexy gun. That must be what they mean by when they say a 1911 is sexy. See? Even a Glock can't resist it. You know what I mean? Anyway. What the fuck was that? See, that was a Glock that just ran by. That Glock was chasing the SIG. I put a thong on the SIG. Remember I said I was going to do that? This is what happens when you don't shoot your guns enough. They start getting horny. Seriously. Alright. We're getting ready to put the mashed potatoes together. I'll season them up and I'll show you that's a whole thing. Be right back. Okay. Getting the garlic mashed potatoes ready. And what I have here is Parmesan cheese, or you can use Lucatelli cheese, whatever kind of grated cheese you want to get. Okay, this is Parmesan. And what I'll do is I have about that much there. And what I'll do, I get 2 cloves of garlic, and I won't chop the garlic up with a knife because I don't want to bite into a piece of garlic when I'm eating mashed potatoes. Who wants to do that? So what you do is, and you don't want it real garlicky, you just want a little hint of garlic. You get a garlic clove and a cheese grater and just grate the garlic with a cheese grater. Don't use a knife because it's, even though you dice it up with a knife, it still makes chunks. You know what I mean? And this is a ton faster. A ton faster. Okay? Like that. Get that nasty thing out of there. Now you flip it over and scrape all that shit out of there. I don't want to touch it because then I'm going to touch my guns and it'll smell like garlic. The last thing I want. You only need a little bit. Alright, next one. Piece of shit cheese grater. This is the best way because the finer you chop garlic, the more flavor it releases. You know what I mean? And that's the fact. Okay. Try not to scrape my fingernail on there. Okay. Now, a lot of it's stuck on that side. But that's all you need. You only need a teeny bit. You want it like a paste. See how it's like a paste? That's good. It's kicking. It's smelling. So that's good. That's about all you want. You don't want too much garlic. Then, you can either season it in the potatoes or the cheese. It don't matter. It's all going in the same spot. A little garlic powder. Because that'll get the garlic taste through the whole thing. And just a little onion powder. Because remember, garlic and onions always go together. Pretty much in every case. And that's it. When the potatoes are done, I'll show you from there. Alright, we're back. Mashed potatoes are in the bowl. See? Partially skinned. And what I'm going to do is pour some. I usually use heavy cream, but we don't have any, so I'll use half and half. Pour some half and half in there. Remember I told you, I don't measure, man. I just add and just keep doing it. Half and half. 3/4 of a stick of butter, or at least a stick of butter. Alright. and my cheese and garlic. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is get it mixing. Now, the first, I use two bits to mix. I use one like this, not yet, and I use one like this. I'm going to use this one first because they're too chunky. This will break it down for me for a while. Then I use the whisk type because we really want to whip the smashed potatoes up. We really want to whip them up, you know what I mean? We'll use that last. Okay. I'll see you in a little bit. Alright. I took the first mixer off because all that does is break it down. This one. And I put the whisk cup type mixer on it. Now we're really whipping it up. Added a lot of salt, a lot of pepper. You gotta re-season the whole thing again, you know? It's just the way it is. And I'll just keep letting that go, man, until it looks real, you know, like whipped spackle. There's guys on this channel, so you know what I mean. If you're a girl, actually, girls should not be watching this video. This is not a good video for women, or I probably will lose all 5% of my women audience. Because it was a little rough in the beginning. It's just fun, guys. You know what I mean? But some girls are cool, man. Some girls can really take a joke. Lima likes really cool. Glampire 13. She's a good sport. No matter what I say, she don't get offended. Because she's cool. She knows I'm only kidding. You know what I mean? So, original metal chick, she never got mad at me. I said some nasty shit, but they know it's just all in fun. Anyway. Yeah, that's looking good, man. That is looking ready to rock and roll. Garlic mashed potatoes. I had to add more butter. So that's a lot of potatoes there, man. There's a whole stick of butter in there. Just what I need. Okay? My tits are big enough. Anyway, I'm going to put it all together and show you what it looks like. See you in a little. Well, there's a finished product. I know before I didn't show you the finished product, but there it is. Italian style chicken cutlets with some canned, they're my favorite, the canned cranberry sauce, and I don't like the other kind because it got stems in it. A lot of people like that, with some homemade from scratch garlic mashed potatoes. Look how nice the potatoes look, nice and whipped. Too bad you can't smell it. And that's it. I will be eating this now. When everyone comes home, they'll be getting the stuff that's reheated. That's just the way it's going to go today. Alright, yes, for another cooking video. Here you go, a big fat one for you. Bill, Fat Mike and Bill, thanks for all your help. Mike from the Firearms Channel really helped me out with my AdSense and my YouTube. He's real good with that stuff. And Bill helps me out all the time with everything. Just want to thank them two guys. Alright, man, don't forget about my man Uncle Slicky Beans.